Hello everyone. In this video, we are simulating a skirmish between 4 Indian Rafales and 6 Pakistani JF-17s. The Indian jets are on a mission to bomb 3 terrorist camps near Skardu Airport, and the Pakistani planes are on a combat air patrol over the area to prevent any such attack. This is of course not 100% realistic, and I have kept it as simple as possible. So, following are the systems involved in this scenario. Pakistan has 6 JF-17 Block 3, each armed with 2 PL-12 and 2 PL-9 air-to-air missiles. They have an ARI AEW aircraft, 135mm anti-aircraft gun battery near Skardu Airport, and one TRS-2230 long-range radar. So India's side has 4 Rafale C, each armed with 2 Meteors, 2 Mika EM and 2 Mika IR air-to-air missiles. Plus, each one of them is carrying one Sniper XR pod and 8 Spice 250 GPS-guided bombs for ground attack. Their primary mission is the destruction of 3 buildings occupied by terrorists near Skardu Air Base. And as target of opportunity, they can attack the Pakistani AEW aircraft, the JF-17, the radar, and open targets at Skardu Air Base if possible. So I have given a bit of advantage to the Pakistanis by reducing the number maximum firing distance of Meteor and Mika ER missiles by 10 to 15 nautical miles. The ranges in this software are all in nautical miles unless mentioned otherwise. So 1 nautical mile is 1.852 kilometers. So, regarding the firing range, I am not sure if one can call it an advantage or disadvantage for either side, as beyond visual range, shots at full range are hardly ever successful against a fast maneuvering target like a fighter jet. We saw one example in 2019 when all the BVR missiles fired by Pakistani F-16s were successfully evaded by Indian Sukhoi 30s. So that now you can see that the Rafales have taken off from Ambala Air Base and will fly an auto-generated flight plan towards Skardu. I have lowered the altitude for some distance and modified the flight plan slightly to keep them from being detected by Pakistanis early. Otherwise, all 4 of them fly at 10,000 meter height and are detected by their AEW aircraft at a distance of 80-200 nautical miles. So, as in my previous video, most of the footage will be from Command Modern Operations Console with a bit from Tech View for the 3D part in between. Here, the Pakistani AEW has detected the rough location of Indian jets and JF-17s are gearing up for the attack. But they are already well within the firing range of Meteors, which are already in the air. The white cone that you see, that you are seeing in front of the planes are their radar coverage area, and the circles around them are the maximum ranges of the weapon they are carrying. I will now change game view to Pakistani side, and the colors will invert. Now Indians will be red and Pakistanis blue till I switch back. 3 JF-17s have already been shot down in the first salvo by Indians, and the remaining are firing off their PL-12. So jets from the both sides are trying to evade missiles by using terrain and countermeasures. Rafales seem to have an upper hand here, perhaps due to their better avionics. Now, the next few minutes of the video will be of this air battle captured from Tech View. If you see a yellow flash at the end of a missile or a bomb's flight path, then it means a successful hit. If there's nothing, then it means that either the target evaded successfully or the weapon had a malfunction. By this point, five JR-17s have already been shot down, and the remaining one is trying to disengage after running out of PL-12s. I think it still has two PL-9 left, but it is not even trying to use them, as it will have to get quite close to the Rafales. The Spice 250 that the Rafales are carrying have a maximum range of 50 nautical miles, and each target has between 2 to 6 bombs assigned to it, even when one or two would have been sufficient. If the targets were assigned manually, then it would have been possible to use them a bit more optimally, and perhaps the airport would have received more hits than it is going to receive now. The final results after the simulation are that Pakistanis lost 5 JF-17s and were unable to prevent Indian Rafales from destroying the terrorist camps, a radar, and two structures at the airport. One interesting part about this run is that they were on back foot as soon as Rafales started firing their meteors and then followed up with Mikas. I have run this simulation 4 to 5 times with more or less the same results. Pakistani jets were never able to stop the Rafales from bombing their targets, and they lost 5 to 6 jets each time. Things changed a bit when I removed Netra from equation, but even then Rafales managed to destroy the ground targets all the time. The JF-17 managed to shoot down one Indian jet in one of the four runs, but even then they lost all or five jets of their own. So to sum up the results, Rafales performed much better than JF-17s even when carrying much heavier payload and outnumbered 1.5 to 1. Of course, this is just a game or at best a somewhat realistic simulation. The actual performance and results may vary in real life. So that's the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Goodbye for now.